Yo, let's do this.
Alright.
We're gonna play. I'm gonna go to the bar.
Let's go to the bar. It's only proper.
I'm gonna give you huge props on that hat. That's great. That's classic Arrow.
Hey, Mr. G.
Please don't call me that.
Whatever you say, sugar beard.
Hello, my heart.
Here we go.
Alright. So, we have an ice arrow loaded.
I thought I was going to hit him.
Yeah. Let's see how you get out of the corner. So far, you're just not. Oh, there you go. That's a way. The stinger. Stinger's back.
Oh.
Ice arrow. Good combo.
No. You thought that was going to hit, didn't you?
So did you.
Yeah, sure did.
Another ice arrow. Now, one of the most important parts about Green Arrow is obviously loading
his
character power arrows. And once he gets them, he becomes a much more powerful character. Hurricane Bow.
Oh.
Ooh, down one still has a lot of range. Still a great poke. Ooh, the hyenas.
Oh, no.
They're hungry.
He hit it.
Good conversion.
How do I?
Oh.
No!
Very good meter burn back three. No combo, though.
Yes.
Interesting. Nice, electric nice, arrow. Nice. Electric arrow's nice. Loaded. You're going to have two of them. Pop, pop. Tyler playing very patient here, but Derek just keeps going in.
Derek just doing Derek's.
Yeah. Oh, back three. Raw back three. Hurricane bow.
No, I missed it again.
Meter burn stinger. All right. Tyler could definitely make a comeback here. Derek just blew all of his meter for no real strategic reason. I respect that. Ice arrow. And he's going to take a round.
All right. All right. Oh, a little fire.
Oh, that's great. Hyenas. Bud and Lou both coming out.
Oh my gosh. Oh, messing it up. Oh, no.
Meter burn back three. Making good work of that hurricane bow.
Oh no.
Oh wow. Tyler on the early stages of a comeback here. Uh-oh, play doctor. That's gonna do some dot damage.
Oh, no.
Raw back three again. What?
Oh, I missed
what?
It.
Ooh.
Here's time.
Oh. Kegs.
No!
Electric arrows. Oh, it's so close. Oh, that's going to do a lot.
No.
Oh, avoided it. Derek has no more meter. He's
meterless.
Definitely not going to have
I'm
a lot for a clash.
Oh, no.
Bud.
Go, dogs. Go.
Lou.
Go. Who's on? Oh, no.
Oh.
There's
still electric arrow. Electric arrow.
Nice, nice, nice. I'm gonna play that one again.
I think that was a good character choice. I think it took you a while to warm up, and then I think once you got going, I think you started off obsessed with the ice arrows.
Yeah, I switched
it up. Right, but once you started switching it up, I thought that was very, very close. So we're just gonna have a straight rematch here.
You didn't want the character.
Sorry. Yep.
Is this too intense? This is way too intense for character intros.
Oh no. Tyler, who's on
TV?
Ice arrow.
Oh, no.
Oh, right on time, delivering.
Beep, beep.
It is very unusual that Ollie would choose to leave the bar.
Right? You're hitting that way more than you used to. You know what I mean?
Backhanded props.
Well, you know what I'm saying, though, right?
No.
Oh, meter burn back three. Tyler has absolutely made hay with that back three.
Sure has. Hey.
Bud? Lou.
Oh, that was the jumper.
That was the jumper.
Okay. Ice arrow. Ice arrow in play. Oh, man. Oh. Nope. Sky alert. It's not looking good, but this isn't the position you were in last time and you ran it back.
Yep.
No.
Oh. Big ice arrow.
I was trying to do that, right?
Just go into that throw, I guess?
No, I was going to try to do the background.
Background
bounce.
Oh, good. Hit her out of it.
Oh, no.
Now, Arrow has full super. Harley with the meter burn roll.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Oh, I thought you said I had full super.
Oh. Oh. Bud and
no,
Lou.
No, nice. Oh.
They travel together.
Oh. Electric arrows. Alright, a lot of hay was made into electric arrows last time. Oh,
come at me,
what
bro.
A panic!
Oh, no! Oh.
Alright.
Okay. This is a very fast-paced gameplay right now.
No, no.
Oh.
Oh, nice.
Oh, no, the sign. How's the weather looking?
You try to catch up with stuff.
Well, everyone knows that's your pit. Oh.
Oh, no, I'm dead.
This corner, this is trouble. Oh no, play doctor. This is a lot of trouble. Wow, 4-3. Just a raw 4-3.
Just throwing it out there.
Oh, meter burn back 3! This is anyone's game.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh jeez. I didn't do anything.
There's still electric arrow.
Oh.
And there you go with the shock. Throw! Throw out of the cartwheel.
Alright, dogs, dogs, dogs.
No one's even thinking about clashing. Oh! That's it! No! No! No. Oh no!
Cupcakes!
Don't panic!
Cupcakes. Cupcakes!
Don't panic!
Cupcakes!
It's
cupcakes!
Everyone's panicking! What? There's not doing enough! What are you guys doing?
That was so dumb! Oh. Apple.
Bullseye.
You can hear people outside yelling about this match.
I can't decide if that was smart play or dumb play.
I may want
like
to change
50,
my character
50.
Here.
You want to?
No.
Okay, let's do this.
Alright.
Yeah, you have to finish. This is, in my opinion, the most exciting match we've had for Injustice 2.
No.
Wow, oh. Very
oh,
fine
come
on that.
Oh, no, I missed it!
No. Oh, the tantrum. Oh my god, the tantrum. TV.
Who's on TV?
Alright, again, Derek in control in the early stages of the match. It's a repeat of what we saw last time. So will Tyler be able to stage a comeback here?
Oh.
Throws her out of the corner. Now she's in the corner. Very good reversal play.
No one puts Harley in the corner.
Oh, oh! They both had the same idea, but Derek wins out. Throwing that scuba equipment.
Ah!
Oh, everybody wants back 3!
No!
Oh, the slide. Tantrum. The tantrum has 100% success rate right now.
Yeah, what's the block on that?
Low.
The same as it always
yeah.
Well, I've always been hit by it, so.
That's true.
All right, Bud and Lou. Oh, just Bud.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Accidental sky alert.
Oh.
Ice arrow hits. This is going to be big damage. Kind of. Oh, the punching. Oh, no.
No,
oh,
sir.
Oh, man. That ice arrow.
Oh, no.
Okay, down 2. Chooses to let the combo go to get an ice arrow. Very smart play. Oh, wow. Wow. Very good dodging.
I
Bud
am throwing
and Lou.
Everything I can at you.
Throw. All right, now. Derek has a sizable life lead, but Tyler has a sizable meter lead. So it's basically dead even, in my opinion. Electric arrow.
Cupcakes.
Oh, those cupcakes do a huge chunk of damage. Bud, no Lou.
Oh.
Oh, Lou gets interrupted. Jumping.
No.
Super. Raw super.
Nope.
Oh, uh-huh. It's blocked. That's a shame.
Oh, no.
Down 1 throw.
Respect the bow.
And I'm sure the world wanted to see it, too.
Electric arrow. Oh, the tantrum.
Oh, Lou.
Lou. Tyler is out of resources. He's out of arrows. He's out of meter. This is his last stand. Oh, finally! What a clutch block! They're both out of resources.
Oh no.
This is it. Oh no, no clash! Oh, what? The cupcake! Lou!
Oh, yeah! Nice. Huh, there could be.
Speaking of catastrophic meltdown.
I knew it was a transition. I knew it.
Let's take a look at Firestorm.
Well, Firestorm is a really, really great zoning character.
A nuclear badass?
He is a nuclear-powered badass. Two minds are better than one. So that makes him good, I guess. he has a really good set of normal attacks that they don't have the greatest range.
You want to kill the button inputs? Just to make it a little easier to see?
Nope. Price options.
I do that too sometimes. There we go, cool.
They don't have the best range, but they do have overhead lows in them. This one ends in a low overhead. This one ends in a low. He has a pretty long string here that he can use to end combos.
So what's his game style? What's his game plan?
His game plan is to keep you far away and to build up his character power, which we'll get to in a minute.
Okay.
So let's go over his special moves. One thing I'll note for later. This is his best overhead attack, which splats them and it just does a little nice chunk of damage. So it's just a decent overhead, but we'll come back to that later.
Okay. Well, so remember that we're going to come back.
Remember
to
you saw that.
Yeah, okay. Remember you saw that. So his main fireball is very, very fast. It does a lot of damage, and it's a high. The meter burn one is a beam that does a boatload of damage and is extremely fast.
Yeah, that is ridiculous.
Definitely one of the better fireballs in the game. So once you've established your fireballs, you can use his molten trap, which is a really cool move that you have to control whether close, medium, or far. And if it hits, it stuns the opponent. You don't get a combo, but it staggers them, and you can go right back to your fireball game. But if you meter burn it, you get a second molten trap.
I'm not moving.
And now you get a combo.
And look at those awesome effects,
too. Oh, it looks amazing.
Let's let it play out.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that's great.
Plenty of time.
Yes. Yeah, you have
plenty
of time.
You're there for a day. You're there for a day.
Yeah, and that's the idea, because he's meant to be played from a distance, so you can do it. And you have plenty of time to get in and do your combo. So this move is going to check the opponent who's trying to dash in, who's trying to just walk away. They're going to have to go low to block that because it's a full screen low attack. And that enables him to go in. So you're wondering, how do you get in?
How do you get in?
He has his torpedo move where he actually turns into nuclear fire and goes all the way across the screen very quickly. Nuclear fire.
Nuclear. Wow. Not your typical fire,
yeah.
Folks.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Nuclear fire.
He can also do this move in the air. So this is a really, really good move to close the gap very quickly.
And if you see somebody jumping,
yes.
Gotcha,
if the opponent is trying to jump back to get away, it's a great move to beat that. Look at that.
Yeah, good stuff.
And it's a good move to use in the air too. You can get behind them. You can get away. And then you're saying, well, what if I have the life lead?
Our players talk to themselves a lot.
they sure do.
Yeah. Wait, is that just me?
Hey, Steve, what if I have the life lead?
And you want to sit on it, right?
And I want to sit on it,
but
yeah.
You're afraid. Superman does a lot of damage, right?
He sure does.
If he gets in, he could lose like half his life, right?
Right.
He has this energy shield, which does a buff. He catches on fire, and now he takes reduced damage for everything. So everything Superman does will do significantly less damage.
You see that super combo I just did?
I'm very surprised you can do that.
And then finally, he has this burst, which is a big burst attack, which is, it's a great wake-up attack. It's a great move to use at the end of your combos.
And I'm just going to sit here and jump.
Thanks for jumping.
It also hits when they're not jumping.
It does.
And the meter burn one is actually a combo start. You can get a back three and then go into your combo. So
you can do some real flashy stuff with all those tools.
You can.
I bet people can.
People can, not us.
His throws are my favorites, I love
that.
Yeah,
it's great. So, earlier I said he's really good at keeping away and waiting for his character power to build. So It seems like that's probably a good time to talk about it. Should
we?
Or should we just wait for May 16th?
May 16th?
Let's talk about the character power.
Are we taking a vote?
I vote for now.
I say now.
Matt?
Sure.
Cool.
May 16th.
Good vote.
Okay. Alright, so you'll notice there's three bars and it's slowly building up. The way it works is it has three levels. And we're waiting for it to build up. And it builds up naturally over time. He doesn't have to do anything. There's nothing the opponent can do to stop it.
Turn that on his, practice,
we can't.
His character power is not filled at the beginning of,
correct.
Of the fight.
You have to wait for it to fill up. Now, when it fills up, you hit the character power button, and he'll get powered up. This makes all of his moves do more damage, and he heals. You can actually see he's healing as he's going. So that's level one. Level two. Level 2 does the same thing, but a little bit better. Now he's healing for double, his moves are doing even more damage, and some of his moves get different reactions. Now, if you can get all the way to level 3, which does take a while, this is something you're only going to be able to do once or twice a match, he really gets powerful.
Well, let's see it. So he's getting more health back.
And this changes a bunch of the reactions of his moves. For example, this is now a combo start.
Ooh.
All of his moves do significantly more damage. Look at his fireball. It actually knocks down, not just the regular one. And look at that.
Mm-hmm. That's heavy pushback.
That's a heavy pushback, right. All of his like, heavy pushback.
Everything is just stay away.
This is another one. This, normally, It knocks you down. It's a low attack. It's nice to mix up with his overheads. With his character power on, it actually becomes a combo starter. Right.
And just something that I wanted to talk about, because I'm really excited about. You saw Steve going into the options.
Yes.
You can now specially set different character powers to what you want them to be doing in your practice, so you don't
right.
have to keep resetting to do things, which I think is a really cool quality of life improvement that you put in.
As a Catwoman player, it's a great blessing to be able to have five scratches. Or this is Firestorm's a great example too, where you can start at level 3, so if you want to practice your combos, you don't have to wait for it to recharge like a real match. So the idea of Firestorm, your basic game plan will be, when you start off, he has great distance moves, and up close, he's okay, but it's nothing spectacular. But if you can get this level 3, if you can go the whole match without needing it, all of a sudden his up close game becomes twice as good as it was. And he's a real threat, and the opponent is going to have to basically try to run away and let that run out so he doesn't have blue fire anymore.
And he has it for quite a while.
And he has it for quite a while. Now the thing is, maybe you don't want to wait for level 3. Maybe you want to heal. So maybe you're about to lose the round. It might be a good idea to go to level 1 or go to level 2. Get a little health back. Do a little bit more damage. Close out the round. But you got to consider you're going to have a harder time getting level 3 later in the game. So there's a lot of character power management here. When do you want to actually activate?
You got to make choices.
Right. And when you've built up a bar, you can hold on to it. It's not like Scarecrow where you have to use it. So you could sit on level 3 until you're comfortable and in a good position to use it.
Right.
Sure.
Let's show those swords.
Splicing Adams over here.
Yep.
So to me, I think ultimately Firestorm is going to appeal to very patient, methodical players that are going to be comfortable keeping people away and waiting for their opportunity. But then the nice thing is, once he gets this going, that's when you can get really creative. So the creative players that like the rushdown, they'll appeal to them too. So if you kind of want to be patient, and then when it's your time, absolutely go in and go nuts, he's definitely someone you should check out.
I would say, you know, if you're playing a grappler and you're like Swamp Thing, like the good thing is if you get in, his wake-ups are fine.
Right.
But like you can do some serious stuff when you're up close.
Right.
Against him. So he definitely has a very distinct way that he'll play.
Yeah.
All right, so what do we got that's special for him?
All right.
Ooh.
Oh, I really like this color. Inverted
really
color.
Really cool one, yeah.
All right, so the first character ability we'll show is Melting Point.
Oh, whoa, hey.
Which is a very quick three-hitting attack. A lot of his special moves are like full screen moves or moves to get in. So this one is actually one you can use up close. It's a great combo ender. It's a great move to use to just push them away if you want to then use his full distance moves.
Right, because I mean, for the most part, he does want to generally stay away.
Right, until of course he gets his character power up.
And then it's party time.
Yeah, it also looks absolutely awesome. His other one that we have here is his Atom Bomb, which is a close, medium, and far bomb that he places on the screen that will then blow up. And you can do it from far, you can do it from close. So it's something you can put on the screen and the opponent has to look for it. And that, again, builds you time for your character power and it can limit them dashing up. Like maybe you think they're gonna try to come in because of this, you can set it up and they get pushed far away. And if they block it, they get pushed far away.
And again, this is only a taste of some of the moves he'll be
getting. Yes. So this is being a great move for every one of those methodical, careful players that likes to set traps and keep the opponent away. And then this one is the opposite. This is for the players that like to just go in, you want to just rush down, you want to do big flashy combos. Or maybe you like to do both, and you can equip both like I did on the slowdown.
That's pretty cool. Pretty awesome.
Check what else you put together, Steve. I think you did good work on the gear set, the loadout this week.
Ooh. I like this one, very futuristic.
I like the glowing matrix.
Yeah.
I would say that most of the things he wears are futuristic.
Thanks, Tyler. Thanks for the support.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, right?
Let's put him where put him in place.
Yep.
All right, so I know what you're thinking.
Mm.
You've shown how great his range is. What about Deadshot? What about Dr. Fate?
Right.
What about characters that zone him out?
Mm-hmm. What will he ever
what
do?
What will he do? Well, I have a loadout for you. This is Vaporize, where he can actually leave the fight line.
He can wow out.
He can wow out.
He's out of here.
And you can hold this down. And you can be gone.
Where did he go?
Where did he go?
I don't know.
Still there. Are you there?
But like, where does he go when he?
Yeah, we don't know. We don't know.
He actually leaves our reality and becomes pure energy.
Is this headcanon again?
No, that's real.
Oh, okay, cool, cool.
And the second one is one of my favorites. It's the air ground spark, where at any point in your jump, you can summon this on the ground. It's a low attack, and it'll knock them down. So this would be really great against maybe Superman as a heat zap. You jump up, you see it, and he gets launched up. And then the meter burn is even cooler.
Oh,
it's
man.
A double hit, does a big chunk of damage.
And keeps him up there for a
minute. And it keeps him up there. So when you combine this with his air torpedo, and his pretty good jump attacks, he can control the air if you have this equipped.
Wow. There it is.
There it is.
Cool.
Yeah.
I think that's...
That is Firestorm.
That's Firestorm. Yeah. Should we show the super one more time?
I think we should.
Sure.
I mean, it's only
we should? Okay.
We like to do them twice in different outfits. Costumes. Mm-hmm. His combo attacks.
Right. His combo attacks have a lot of range with his sickle. His back three has a ton of range. His 4-3 is an overhead that reaches almost all the way across the screen.
So would you say this is the longest reaching 4-3?
This is the longest reaching 4-3 in the history of Injustice.
Okay, very good.
Now, the trade-off is they're not very fast and they have a lot of recovery.
Right.
So if you're a player that likes kind of a slower pace, but you want to keep the opponent away, he'll be a great character. He also has forward medium attack, light attack, hard attack, which is a very good long-range move. It's a mid-attack.
And it advances you, too.
And it advances him. He goes forward. He has a low attack with good reach for a low attack that ends in an overhead.
What a mix-up.
Hey, can you show the trap real quick? I don't think we really have seen that much.
Well, he's a power character.
Okay, never mind.
Hold on.
Oh, cool.
You know, he could have just given me control, but he's like, no.
Oh, trap.
Oh.
Oh, my foot! That's my second favorite interactable in the game.
I think it's actually, yeah, my second favorite too.
Okay, cool.
The crocodile's pretty awesome.
Yeah. So, he also has like a good knockdown string. And he has strings that have overheads and lows in the middle. He's not really a character that opens you up with overheads and lows. They're more part of his combo attacks.
So if you land like the first hit, you're
right.
Get
then the opponent has to go lower overhead. It's not the initial hit.
Right. So you got to really learn his combo strings to fight against.
And then he has a forward one. It's this long range headbutt, which I love.
Woo!
Look at that.
Nice.
Nice little. Lunge.
And you can see his sweep has a ton of range. It's probably the longest range sweep attack.
Jeez.
His uppercut has a ton of range, so it's a great anti-air. His jump attacks have great range. He's kind of one of the masters of ranged combat.
Controlling space.
Yes.
He's in a weird way a melee zoner.
Right. That's a good way to describe him.
Yep.
So we can go into... Oh, he also has a really cool throw. Uh-oh. I love how he just drags you down. All right. So his special attacks. We'll start off with Death Sickle, or Death Spin, which is a multi-hitting attack. And he can actually advance with it. So he can go forward. Or he can retreat if you want to intimidate the opponent. And this can be meter burned into a combo star.
Wow.
And then you get a back three.
Or do you? Do you?
Man, this is scary.
You're really landing it right now.
There you go.
There we go.
So this is like his main combo starter. If you hit his low, you can go into it. Pretty much any time you're going to hit. You know, you can use it as punish, you can go into it. It's like the main way you're going to extend your combos.
Gotcha.
Then he has his gas puke. And this move you can actually hold down to extend it. So you can do a short one and be safer on block, or you can do the full one. He also has a gas burst, which is a quick, somewhat safe burst that you can use to end strings. Like if you think the opponent might block, or if you want to just knock them away to go back to your range of attacks. And he can also do this in the air.
Ooh.
It also has it'll do a slight dot damage, and it has another use that involves his character power we'll talk about later.
Okay.
He has this hook attack, which is a great combo ender. It'll knock him down. Leaves him right next to you. It does a good chunk of damage. And the meter burn does even more damage and looks absolutely awesome. really nice dose of fear gas.
So cool.
Yeah. So that's definitely one of his best combo enders. He has a teleport. Since I said earlier his moves are on the slower side and have a lot of recovery, if the opponent has long range or projectile attacks that are very fast, he'll get beat out. So if you're struggling to get in, you can actually use this teleport to go right behind
him. Just drops into fear blocks. Right. Yeah, that's awesome.
He can also use it for tricks. You know, you can knock them down, then they're blocking the other way, and you go in.
You're fighting a nightmare at this point.
Yep. Yeah. It's definitely pretty scary to have this giant creature show up right behind when you're trying to use your batarangs. He also has a command grab, which is what I said earlier, where he doesn't really fit into an archetype because he's not a grappler. He's a long range character, but then he has a grapple, which is, in my opinion, one of the cooler moves in the game.
Because there's his, you've seen the both versions
of
them. Yes. How is this possible?
Through Jonathan Crane's fear gas, anything is possible. Your worst nightmares come to life.
Oh my.
And he has some really good tick throws. It's down one, it's standing three.
Explain a tick throw real quick.
Well, a tick throw is when you do a normal attack and then you special cancel into the grab. And if the opponent keeps blocking, they'll get thrown.
Right.
So the opponent has to make a read and jump out or do a meter burn back three or attack them or backdash away. It basically means you do a normal attack and you combo into it and you can't just keep blocking. So then once the opponent starts to try to jump out, so I said this is a good tick throw. Then you can start doing the actual string. And if they jump out, they're gonna get hit.
Awesome. That's one of my favorites.
That's definitely one of the cooler
strings.
Really
cool. So any other special moves you want to talk about?
Or should we break down that gimmick?
That
character power.
Come on.
Oh, he also has this energy wave.
Oh.
And this will actually absorb projectiles. So again, if he's struggling because his moves are on the slower side and he's getting zoned out by batarangs, he can use this. And the meter burn one will do a double one and it'll knock them far away.
I wish I could throw batarangs, but I'm not.
And you can actually combo off this.
Derek would like to throw a batarang.
Can I throw batarangs, please? No. See how fast he did that?
Yeah, I'm not very fast at it.
There you go.
Look at that. There you go. Beats projectiles.
Whew.
Super
Steve
cool.
Steve is a professional. That's what I like about Steve.
So he has great tools to keep you away where he wants to be. He has pretty good tools when he gets up close. And he has good tools if you're trying to keep him away. So at full screen, he's at his absolute best. He's a total nightmare.
Good one.
Gotcha.
Character power. His character power is his fear meter. You can see it at the bottom. So how it works is you activate it, and he gets even scarier. And now he starts doing dot damage when he's close to the opponent. So
dot damage being?
Damage over time. They'll start taking damage just by standing next to him. And you can see that it's filling the fear meter. Now, you're not expected to get a full fear meter on just one dose of this poison. You can see I almost did. So the idea is you keep fighting, and then you activate it again, and you get a chunk. Now it's full. Now you can see it's glowing green and it's draining.
Whatever does this do, Steve?
This does traumatize, which is a full screen ground pound.
Ooh. Is that guaranteed damage or?
All the follow-ups are guaranteed damage. The actual ground pound is blockable, but it's very fast. It reaches all across the ground. So the idea is once you build up the sphere meter, which will take you a little trouble, you have this ground pound active.
Which they are afraid of
the
entire game.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And then you sit on it, you make them fear them. You wait for movement, you look for a little twitch, traumatize, and then you get a big combo.
That's really cool.
You can also use it as combo extender. You don't have to do it from far away. You know, you could if you hit this, just go straight into it and then get a big damaging combo from up close.
Wow.
Oh, that's awesome.
Now, that's cool.
The dot damage isn't the only way to build a sphere meter. His scarecrow gas also builds it. So if you do this move, this one.
Sorry.
You'll see it's also building it up as it hits.
Oh, so anytime the gas hits.
Anytime he hits with a gas move, it'll build it up as long as it's active. So the idea here is when you feel like you're comfortable in a good position to get in, you activate it, you start getting close to them. And just by being close to them, they're going to take damage. Like you go for a throw, which wastes a lot of time with it and does a lot of the dat damage. You can start ending your combos in this move to get it up. Then when you get it, you can go back to playing full screen, back to controlling space, and the opponent knows. If you throw a batarang, if you try to do a back three or dash in, you gotta look out for that ground pound and you're in a lot of trouble.
So once it's full, you don't actually have to activate it right away. You can just sit on it.
Right, you can sit on it while it's draining. And the opponent sits there and they know they gotta try to wait it out.
That was a lot of damage.
That was a lot of damage.
That's a lot of damage.
Really cool.
And then his super move.
One of my favorites.
This The beginning of the super move is just amazing.
She rips a hole in reality.
And at the end, he puts them into
their own grave.
Go visit your parents, Batman.
Wow, that's
nice.
Like, did we really have to go there?
I think we all know what happened.
Sorry.
Wow.
All right. Well, you know what? It's just, you know, Scarecrow brings the wits out of you.
Yes, you're right. So that's awesome. That's kind of your walkthrough, basically, of how Scarecrow works.
That's the basics of the default loadout Scarecrow.
I hope a lot of people really enjoyed seeing Scarecrow, but we do have, you put these together, actually.
Some loadouts.
We have some really awesome loadouts for Scarecrow. Let's take a look at those.
Yeah, in my opinion, Scarecrow has some of the top five, I'd say, gear in the game. Very, very cool stuff.
I'm glad you're numbering things in your head.
Yeah, well, as you know, I have a rating system in my head.
Right. So here we go. Sort of like, you went for a bone
theme. A bone themed, the bones of his victims.
Ooh. His victim was a horse.
Yeah.
So his accessory there is his accessory his hook?
It is. And you can now see it has a bone on it, and you'll see another one later that's
Don't spoil it.
All right, so the first ability we're going to show is Soaring Murder, where you notice he has great range, but he didn't really have a standard projectile. Yeah. This replaces his energy wave move with crows.
His fear for now?
Yeah.
Murder.
A murder of crows. And the meter burn one is even more crows, and it's a knockdown. They also move a little bit slower. So he can kind of follow them. And this gives him a traditional projectile. The regular one's pretty fast. The meter burn one takes up a ton of space and is a mid. So if you're playing a match where you're really struggling against projectiles, even with this projectile absorption, you now have a projectile on your own.
Nightmare Eater on Twitch just said, Scare Horse confirmed.
Ooh.
I mean, it's apparently dead.
What's on his other arm? Is that just a giant bird mouth?
I think that's a bird mouth.
Oh, wow.
If you guys recall, in The Dark Knight Returns, Batman actually rides a horse. So my personal headcanon right now is Scarecrow killed the horse and made armor out of it to scare Batman.
That is not Injustice canon.
No, that's my personal headcanon.
Do not think that is Injustice canon.
That's
Brownback. I love your headcanon.
Yeah, that's my headcanon.
Right.
Wow.
Cool. What else do we give him?
The second ability we gave him actually enhances the Fearnado, and it makes it slide across the screen. It will absorb a projectile still, and then it actually becomes a projectile, and it's a low-hitting, very fast projectile that you can use. So this loadout in particular I made to be an anti-zoning loadout. This is the loadout that you would use against like a Superman or a Deadshot or Dr. Fate if you want to go in and use your own projectiles. Or you could use it against the character we just saw, Gorilla Grodd, or any other grappler or brawler like Swamp Thing that has trouble against projectiles.
Right,
awesome.
Now, I like this one.
Mm-hmm.
The next one's my favorite.
Yes.
You don't have to switch my blade.
It's okay, it's just worse of habit. Don't stop him.
Yeah, don't stop him, don't stop him.
All right.
Plague.
Plague Doctor.
So cool.
So yeah. I have to say as well that I love Scarecrow's gear.
Yes.
Mm. He's got some of the coolest stuff. I love the gas mask. Everybody allowed to talk about a problem. Oh, well, it's too late.
There
it
is.
But he's got some of the most unique gear of building that whole nightmare feeling of him, or fear.
Yes.
This one is legit scary. And he's wearing a tie. So this is sort of business
it's
casual.
Also a little, yeah, it's a little casually. I mean, casual. You know, he is a psychiatrist.
Right, so he's got
he
business.
He is a doctor, yeah. Right.
He's got business.
Well, the stream just went nuts. So
okay.
That's good.
So, what we got so here? In theme with the Plague Doctor outfit, I gave him his move Plague. And this, that's who we've already seen.
Yep.
It replaces his Fearnado again, and it gives him this B attack, which comes up from the ground and then is a combo starter. So this is a great move for use against anyone that likes to hit buttons on the ground. It'll regulate them. You'll get a combo. Look at the range of that. That's good. That's a good move.
Now, what we've talked about too is that some of these gear related abilities will take up more than one slot.
Right.
This one does.
This is a two slot. This is such a good move to balance it out. It'll take two instead of one. So, the kind of metagame here is the plague is a great move, but if you use this, you can't equip another ability. So if you really like the low sliding Fearnado, you can't equip these at the same time. So. And that's why we have multiple loadouts. So you can actually make three different loadouts to have. This is the one I use against projectiles. This is the one I use against grapplers. This is the one I use for matchups that are favorable to me. This is the one I use because this move just looks awesome.
Right. And that, to me, that's important to me.
Yeah.
I want to look cool. Awesome. I don't want to do cool stuff.
Yeah.
That's fine, right?
Yeah. No. Awesome.
No, that's totally valid.
Do you want to do his super again? Because it's super fun.
I do want to do it again.
Oh, you can see him up close too. And it's the. That's what's cool to me is the super has been here.
Yeah.
Like that's awesome.
Yeah.
And probably a challenge for the team. So nice job, everybody.
Way to go,
ladies and gentlemen. That.
That Scarecrow.
Is part of Scarecrow. There's still more. Oh, there's we're not going to show.
There's more.
We're not showing.
That's just a tease. Yeah.
You looked at me all like, "What are you talking about?"
Well, no, that's pretty much it. About, yeah.
<There's> Honestly, this is a family stream, and
I don't know about that, but I guess
stealing my joke when you saw where I was going with it.
Look, so, you're closer to 800 pounds. Yeah, well, makes sense.
You know, he's not a trained fighter like Batman is, right? He's more animalistic and wild. Obviously, he's a gorilla, but we wanted to translate that in his moves as well. So a lot of his moves are like these full body motions, really kind of primal and like ragey type moves. Along with his strength, like he also feels, because he's so smart, that he is so much better than his opponents. So he kind of wants to just not only hit them and move, just destroy them, but just pure dominance is right. What he wants to do.
And it's a really cool line you're going through, because he's very strong and powerful and feral almost.
Yeah.
But he's also very smart.
Exactly.
So two different ways to play.
Right.
So let's, but they work together.
Absolutely. And you'll see him shine within like the medium to close range. You know, he's really got some good tools to kind of get in close, because he's not really a zoner type guy. He's right. Rushed down more or less, or just kind of just get in your face. So, you know, we could see some of those moves.
Right, let's do it.
Let's talk about it. So let's start with sort of his some of the strings he has.
Some of his normal attacks.
His normal attacks are really cool because a lot of them involve grabs and throws.
Absolutely.
And can be meter burn.
Absolutely, yeah.
So let's start with something that, like, we have the, this one's super awesome.
I love this one, yeah.
Pounce and choose him out.
This is, you know, Feral right there, right? He's like eating his face, so.
Which can also be
meter burns.
Monkey
extend.
Flip them over you.
It's monkey flip.
Awesome.
I think he would be offended by that.
He might be. Mm-hmm. He also has. What else we got?
You could do the 2-2-3.
2-2-3 is an amazing move. The bite again, real quick. And these are all just good rush down maneuvers. This pushes it back.
Right.
A great pushback maneuver.
Yeah. And the one away throw.
And just like you were saying, Pete, like, he's swinging those arms around, right? Like,
absolutely.
And which is giving him also good reach on some attacks as well, too, which is great.
Now, that's a standard three. Now, that's a three hit right there, which is pretty cool.
And let me go through real quickly my favorite move he has, which we just showed, which is the clothesline, right?
Right.
But you can also need to burn the clothesline. Oh, missed
and
it.
And miss a combo.
Miss a combo. Don't get used to it, everybody. And then finish a combo.
The monkey brush.
Right. And he does a fair bit of damage. Mm-hmm. He's a big bruiser.
Yeah, once he gets in, you're in trouble.
Right, so keeping him out is a great idea.
Absolutely, but he's got tools to get in.
Yes, so. He does.
He doesn't monkey around.
Oh.
Huh? Alright. Alright, moving on.
One of my favorite moves, it's not like a combo maneuver, but one of the things I really like to do is his back two.
Yes.
It's a really good...
It's good utility.
A nice range to it. And it also kind of gives a little bit of a stagger, so you can throw. I mean, it's not a combo, but like you can really mix people up that way.
Absolutely.
And something that people don't know is the thing we call in the building, the secret sweep. So he has it down one right there, his little poke.
It's pretty quick too.
He also has,
a leap.
He also has a leap that I did.
Which is a secret sweep.
He can also go further with his sweep by lunging at the opponent.
It's great reach.
It's a good long-reaching sweep.
Awesome. Let's discuss a little bit some of his special moves.
Yes, absolutely. So, let's do the stampede since we kind of saw that.
Right.
So, you know, this is really good if you're far away and you really want to get close. The nice thing about this is you can cancel this at any time.
So I can.
Oh.
It's a good move for players who play this character because the way it kind of resembles a little bit of his forward dash. So you might confuse people like, is he dashing or not?
Absolutely.
So then you can do something like this, come in, hit him once. Come in, cancel, and then get in for a throw.
Or the secret sweep.
Or secret sweep them, which is important. There it is.
But what's really nice is if you meter burn that, he really picks up the speed. He'll get to his opponent real quick, and then if he hits him, you know, you do this like pretty vicious combo.
Yeah, so I didn't know he was faster.
Yeah, he's much faster.
Yeah, cool. He's much faster. So that's a great move for him. What else do we want to go through here?
We could talk about the leap. That's another good one to get in close.
So he can, he has a huge leap, which he can do from different...
Yeah, you can push back or forward to kind of change the distance on it, how far he goes. And during, while he's airborne, you can press one of your, kind of your face buttons to do a different attack, right?
One of your air attacks?
Air attacks, yeah. Yeah.
But, that's not all either.
Tell me more!
You can do, I was too close, I didn't do it right, sorry.
Yeah, that's the throw button, right?
Right, which also, another, I mean, this guy, if you have some meter, you're gonna do some damage.
That's right.
Because he can also flip him up, too.
Yep.
For some more continuation, so.
Great. He also has a ground pound.
Oh, right.
It's a pretty short range move, but if you're pretty far away and you really want to poke the guy, you can meter burn that,
right.
And it travels full screen.
And you see the ground sort of lift. That's
there's
awesome.
There's that effects team.
Effects team.
Going back to the effects.
And, do it again. And also, like, just doing things, you know.
Yeah.
Like one
absolutely.
Hit, it's a real good mix of tools, too.
And for the most part, too, with Brad, you're going to want to do your combos that end with leaving your opponent next to you or as close
right.
to you as possible, right?
Yeah.
And so ending it with that ground pound is really good so that you can get back onto the
right.
opponent.
Absolutely.
We didn't show what it was. Just this. His throw.
This is my favorite move.
His throw is just, it's so Gorilla Grodd.
Yeah.
So Gorilla Grodd. Man, that's Gorilla Grodd.
Also, shout outs to Conduct. Mm-hmm. One of our newer stages you get to see here, too.
Well, have we not shown this?
It's been in some trailers.
Okay.
But ooh. Here it is, Conduct, everybody.
Ooh.
Right. Talk about his trait.
His trait, yeah, his character power. So here it is, he...
gains psionic powers here. So a couple of his... he gets some new strings.
Show some of those, here we go.
Yeah, so Torch 2 throw. All right, it's another kind of in your face.
Right.
Great.
That's a good combo ender when you have that one.
Yes.
For sure.
And then Torch 2, one.
Boom.
Yep. And then also, kind of from here, he gets the ability to do mind control, which you showed, which is down back to you.
Yep.
Yeah, and this is cool because if you meter burn that, you can just run in and you got this huge advantage
right.
on
he
it.
Makes them hit themselves.
Absolutely.
Which yeah. is amazing.
And it gives you a special power that's got really good reach as
yep.
well.
Yes.
Right? So, I mean, you can get them from a good distance, right. mind control them, rush up, and go into combo.
Yeah, if you're kind of stuck in that medium zone, that will, or a little bit further, that will really give you some opportunities. He also has a psionic lift. That's a good one.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks. Is this, that is, we're talking...
Down, down, one. So from here, he has this, like, mode where he has this little floating ability. From there, you can kind of dash forward or back to gain some mobility.
Right.
But, you know, if you can cancel out of that. Either by pressing down, down, or if you want to do like a medium range burst, press one.
That did the wrong one.
Well, that's fine, too.
Yep.
So one, that's really nice because it's pretty quick and it hits really far.
Right.
So you could kind of dash past and then
right.
hit the one and then you cross them up and then do stuff. Two is the ground pound there, and you can meter burn that. What I really like about the meter burn is it's full screen pop up. So you
yep.
can be really far away, be up in the air, come down, and pop it.
So we'll do something like...
Boom. Yeah, yep. exactly.
Now right. knock him down, get in, do more damage.
Do whatever you want to do.
Right on.
But let's say you really have a problem with against zoners.
As big characters?
It's fair enough. Yeah. Like, if there's not enough tools for him, and someone's just really, like, fireballing you or whatever, you know, throwing whatever at you, if you turn on your trait and then... you have this
down three.
Savage Strength move, you'll eat projectiles for like quite a long time.
And then that gets him back in. So you're yeah. you're getting zoned out here, turn it on, and I'm just walking in.
Yeah, do whatever you gotta do.
Yeah, that's pretty
powerful. Mm-hmm. It's pretty powerful.
It only lasts, you know, a certain amount of seconds, and it only happens when his trait is on.
Correct.
So you gotta pick your timings.
Yes.
So definitely a super cool character. I've been playing with him a lot. We've had some matches.
We have
had a lot of fun. With Gorilla Grodd. Awesome.
Want to show his super?
His super, right.
Let's do it.
His super is awesome because it's just like straight up brutal.
Yeah.
And he uses both brains and brawn during.
That's right.
So let's see that.
Oh, you comboed into it.
Yeah, thanks, man.
I didn't think you could. Shows that animal side of him. He's still animal on the inside.
Debo305 on Twitch just said, I found my main. Everyone seems to be really enjoying Gorilla Grodd right now.
Great.
So good for you.
So you know what? Maybe we should show him some more stuff then.
Oh, we do have some cool some cool gear setups ready to go.
Let's do it.
I'm gonna do one more combo
oh,
there.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So I'd go to. I always do it wrong.
There you go.
Do it wrong.
Oh, there it is.
Here we go.
You gotta show off the way too, some of its utility.
Oh, the way. Oh, right.
In there.
So first off, you want to flip stance him? So
there we go.
See this amazing gear. Looks so right.
Golden with the we got the green. Horn there, pretty awesome.
The emerald horn.
Emerald, yes, it's emerald, I apologize.
That's all right. I mean, he's royalty.
We were talking about the way too, as yeah. well. Like, this is really cool. So you can actually, like, do this sort of thing, and then restand,
yeah.
which is awesome.
Which is important to his game.
Yes,
playing,
exactly.
Right?
There are also combos, which they're doing in QA. I can't do one today, but it's because it's a little challenging for me, but I'm getting there, where you can actually set this up into a throw,
yeah,
and
I've
then
seen that.
I actually just did it. So wow, that's really
I can't
cool too.
You did it.
Oh, and the cross up leap.
Yeah, this move here. When you,
yeah.
Yeah. You. So his two spins around, so you can actually cross up with it real easily, and then jump over them and cross up too. So
he's got a lot of fun tools.
Let's check out some of the which moves did I add here.
I don't know.
I gotta find.
Well, it probably isn't a new combo.
Is this the anti?
Let's see. Let's try this. Not that.
No.
Steve wrote them down. We're going to find them real quick. Unless we somehow didn't get them put in.
Well, you know.
Oh, right.
Let's see.
I don't think they're put in, actually. I think we may have made a mistake and not had them put in. So that's not on Matt Burke. That's on me.
Can we blame Burke
like
anyway?
To still blame Burke for it.
We will blame Burke for that. Let's take a look at another one of his sweet, sweet costumes.
Absolutely. What else does he have?
We have some really cool. This next one is my favorite one. Let's take a look here.
Just ooh, I like the
skulls and crazy stuff.
That's what I usually wear on the weekends. Skulls
right.
and spikes.
So, just some. He has some really neat gear. Yeah, they did not save. So.
Well, either way, we got awesome looking gear for Grodd.
Right.
He's got a lot of really great abilities that he has as well. So, like, one of them that we're not being able to currently show is his anti-air drill, which
yeah.
really does help out for his game.